Hi everyone, marhaba, this is Sharig and welcome back to another lesson with Globetrot with Arabic. It's going to be a Lebanese Arabic lesson dedicated to my Lebanese Arabic learners. We will do a small passage. I was inspired to write this passage because I was speaking to my friend in Lebanon and I was asking him how he was and how he was spending his quarantine days. So he told me he was in the garden doing some gardening and planting some flowers. So I said, you know what, I'm gonna take everything you told me and I'm gonna share it with my students so that they can also make the most of your experience. So I hope you enjoy it. Before I begin, let me send you all my wishes. I hope you are all very, very safe, very well surrounded. I hope you're feeling comfortable. You have enough food in your fridge so you can keep going for the next 14 days or 30 days, who knows. I know it's difficult times for all of us, including myself, but let's try, at least try, to be positive and make the most of the free time that we are having. Maybe we can do more of the things we always wanted to do, maybe learn Arabic or learn anything else we wanted to learn. Let's begin. Okay guys, let's begin. I'm gonna start as usual by reading fast because it's important for you guys to listen to the real natural speed that we use when we're speaking Arabic in Lebanon. But after that, I'm gonna read slower the second time round, and later on I'm gonna of course break every single detail down. Let's begin. من شوي كنت عم بحكي مع رفيقي روني بلبنان على التليفون. سألته كيف عم بيقضي وقته بالحجر. قال لي إنه عم بيشتغل من البيت هالفترة وعم بيستفيد من وقته قد ما في. اليوم مثلاً كان بجنينة عم بيسقي الزريعة كل بعد الظهر. قال لي كمان إنه في عنده بركة على التراس كان بدها تنظيف، فنظفها كتير منيح وشال العشب كله. من بعدها نكش الأرض وزرع زهور جديد. بعت لي صورة لجنينة من بعد ما خلص شغل، رح فرجيكن إياها. وإنتو شو عم تعملوا هالأيام؟ عم تقعدوا بالبيت أو لا؟ Let's repeat this a little bit slower using Latin script. من شوي كنت عم بحكي مع رفيقي روني بلبنان عالتليفون. سألته كيف عم بتقضي وقتك بهالحجر؟ قال لي إنه عم بيشتغل من البيت هالفترة وعم بيستفيد من وقته قد ما فيه. اليوم مثلاً أو مثلاً كان بجنينة عم بيسقي الزريعة كل بعد الظهر. قال لي كمان إنه في عنده بركة عالتراس كان بدها تنظيف، فنظفها كتير منيح وشال العشب كله. من بعدها نكش الأرض وزرع زهور جديد. بعت لي صورة جنينة من بعد ما خلص شغل فيها، رح فرجيكن إياها. وانتو شو عم تعملوا هالايام؟ عم تقعدوا بالبيت او لا؟ يلا let's break every single detail down. I'm gonna start by reading the first sentence one more time very slow and then tell you what exactly every word means. من شوي كنت عم بحكي مع رفيقي روني بلبنان عالتليفون. من شوي literally from a little bit, which means a while ago. And when I say min shway, it doesn't mean a while ago in terms of a few months ago or a few weeks ago. No, you can understand here that it was a few minutes ago or maybe 1 or 2 hours ago. Okay? Min shway, from a bit or a while ago. Kint am bihke, I was talking. Bihke means I talk. Ana bihke. Am bihke means I am talking. كنت عم بحكي, when we add كنت or كنت, you can pronounce it كنت or كنت, it means I was talking. So that's how you change the present continuous into the past continuous. So عم بحكي is I am talking. كنت عم بحكي means I was talking. من شوي كنت عم بحكي مع رفيقي روني بلبنان. مع means with. رفيق means friend. رفيقي means my friend. Roni is his name. بلبنان. B means in and لبنان means Lebanon. You notice here I didn't write B لبنان. I wrote بلبنان. I could have said of course B لبنان, but I abbreviated it and I said بلبنان. When you talk fast you pronounce it that way and it sounds a bit more native even. So من شوي كنت عم بحكي مع رفيقي روني بلبنان. You see, there's even a liaison between روني بلبنان. Okay? عاد تليفون, literally on the phone. But you notice here I wrote عاد تليفون. But if we look here in Arabic, it's written عال تليفون. I didn't pronounce the L, and that's why I wrote here the phonetic representation of the way we pronounce it basically in Arabic, عال تليفون, not the way we write it. So it's written عال تليفون, but it's pronounced عال تليفون. Why? Because the word telephone starts with a T, ta, the ta letter. And all the words in Arabic that start with a T, the ta letter, when we add L before them, we don't pronounce the L because the ta is a sun letter. Now, of course, if you say al telephone, it's fine, it's not the end of the world, but it sounds less native and it's more correct, of course, to say al telephone. So, من شوي كنت عم بحكي مع رفيقي روني بلبنان على التليفون. سألته, I asked him. سألت is I asked. سألته is I asked him. So when I pronounce سألت on its own, just I asked, I don't say سألت, I can, but many times I pronounce it as سألت, I asked. But when I say سألت and when I want to add the O in the end to say I asked him, I don't say سألتو, no, I just say سألتو, سألتو. I kind of drop this أ sound here. So سألتو, I asked him, كيف عم بتقضي وقتك بهالحجر؟ كيف عم بتقضي وقتك بهالحجر؟ كيف means how. بتقضي, بتقضي, written here in Arabic as بتقضي, and this قاف is pronounced as a همزة. That's why you see I wrote here a number 2 which represents the أ sound, because this قاف is always pronounced as a أ when you're speaking Arabic, when you're speaking Lebanese Arabic. So we don't say بتقضي. In most areas actually of Lebanon we say بتقضي, but there are some areas and some groups actually who, that pronounce it بتقضي. For example, we have the Druze in Lebanon that pronounce بتقضي instead of بتقضي. But generally speaking, the most of the country pronounces it as بتقضي. So كيف عم بتقضي, how are you spending? So بتقضي is you spend, عم بتقضي is you are spending, كيف عم بتقضي is how are you spending, كيف عم بتقضي وقتك. وقت means time and وقتك means your time. So of course now you know that when you add وقتي it means my time. وقتك, your time feminine, وقتك if you're talking to a woman. كيف عم بتقضي وقتك masculine, كيف عم بتقضي وقتك feminine, كيف عم بتقضي وقتك بهالحجر. حجر, we said in yesterday's lesson, it means quarantine. The full expression as I said is حجر صحي or حجر منزلي. صحي means health and منزلي means home isolation or home quarantine. منزلي, pronounced as منزلي. But because we're using this term a lot recently or lately, so we're not saying بهالحجر المنزلي or بهالحجر الصحي. No, we are saying بهالحجر. We are just abbreviating the term. So what does بهال mean? I can break this down and say B, which means in, plus هيدا, which means this, and ال means the. But what we did here is we abbreviated the هيدا plus the ال together and we said هل, which means this, and بي هل means in this, بي هل. Again, instead of saying بهل, I can even abbreviate things further and say بهل instead of بهل. So all of this, ب, هيدا, إل, becomes بهل. In this, basically. بهل حجر, in this quarantine. Let's repeat the whole thing. I'm gonna read the Arabic script. من شوي كنت عم بحكي مع رفيقي روني بلبنان على التليفون. Repeat after me. من شوي كنت عم بحكي مع رفيقي روني بلبنان على التليفون. سألته، I asked him، كيف عم بتقضي وقتك بهالحجر؟ Let's continue. Let's see what he said. This is a true story, by the way. I was just talking to him. قال لي إنه عم بيشتغل من البيت هالفترة وعم يستفيد من وقته قد ما في. اليوم مثلا or مثلا كان بالجنينة عم بيسقي الزريعة كل بعد الظهر. Let's break this down. قال لي means he told me. You notice here I wrote قال لي. قال لي in standard Arabic. قال لي. We write it قال but we pronounce it إل. إل when it's alone. But when I want to say he told me, I pronounce it as if it's one word here. You see, I wrote قال لي. قال لي. And this لي here is this لي. Basically, in Arabic, what you are saying is said, he said, for me, which means he told me. قلي قلي. So, قلي إنه عم بيشتغل من البيت هالفترة. قلي, he told me إنه that. He told me that عم بيشتغل, he's working. So, بيشتغل means he works. If you want to change the present simple into present continuous, you add the عم. عم يشتغل, he works, من البيت, literally you are saying من, from, ال, the, بيت, means house, from the house, which means from home, هالفترة, هل means هيدي الفترة, remember the abbreviation of هيدي plus ال, هيدي الفترة, by the way, of course you can say هيدي الفترة, but I'm abbreviating it here and I'm saying هالفترة. فترة means a period of time or phase. So when I say هل فترة means in this phase or during these times. So قال لي إنه عم بيشتغل من البيت هل فترة. He told me that he is working from home in this phase or these days. وعم بيستفيد من وقته قد ما في. And عم بيستفيد. بيستفيد is he benefits. عم بيستفيد is he is benefiting. وعم بيستفيد and he is benefiting. وعم بيستفيد من وقته from his time. So وقت means time. وقته means his time. قد ما في. So قد ما في means as much as he can. قد ما في. Memorize it as an expression. قد ما في. So here the ma is not the negative ma. No, it's part of adma, as much as. Adma fi. Fi means he can. Now if you want to say as much as I can, you can say adma fiye. You add the adma fiye. Okay? So, قال لي إنه عم بيشتغل من البيت هالفترة. He told me that he is working, which means he's been working, من البيت, from the house or from home, هالفترة. This phase or during this phase or these days. وعم بيستفيد من وقته and he's benefiting from his time قد ما في, as much as he can. اليوم مثلا, or you can also pronounce it مثلا. اليوم means today and مثلا or مثلا is for example. It means for example. Here I wrote it again مثلا, مثلا, but in standard Arabic, you will find it written as مثلاً ث. And this ث is usually pronounced either as a ت or a س in Lebanese Arabic. So we don't say مثلاً in Lebanese Arabic, we say مثلاً or مثلاً. For example, اليوم, today, اليوم مثلاً, today for example, كان بالجنينة عم بيسقي الزريعة كل بعد الظهر. كان بالجنينة. بال means in the. جنينة means garden. كان بالجنينة. He was in the garden. عم بيسقي. بيسقي means to water. Ambius e, he is watering. But here we have the can, you see? It's separated by in the garden, biljnaine. So it's can ambius e, he was watering, okay? So, huwe bius e, he waters the flowers or the plants. Huwe ambius e, he is watering the flowers and the plants. Huwe can ambius e, he was watering the flowers or the plants, okay? So, كان بالجنينة, he was in the garden. عمبيوس الزريعة. الزريعة means plants. الزريعة, pronounced as الزريعة, means the plants. You notice again here, it's written الزريعة, but it's pronounced الزريعة. Again, because the word starts with the Z sound, and all the words in Arabic that start with the Z sound, the Zain, we don't pronounce the L before them. So instead of saying الزريعة, say الزريعة. So عمبيوس الزريعة. You notice also here I wrote الزريعة, but if I'm reading faster and I'm putting this liaison from عمبيوس الزريعة, you know, I'm not even pronouncing the E here. It's like it becomes a double Z. عمبيوس الزريعة. Say it with me. عمبيوس الزريعة. Good. So, عمبيوس الزريعة كل بعد الظهر. كل in another context would mean every. But here it means all. And it means all afternoon. In that sense of all. So, بعد الظهر means after the noon. That's how you say it in Arabic. You say after the noon. بعد الظهر, again pronounced as بعد الظهر because the dot is a sun letter. So, كل بعد الظهر, all afternoon. Let's repeat this part. قال لي إنه عم بيشتغل من البيت هالفترة. He told me that he's working from home during this period. وعم بيستفيد من وقته قد ما في. And he's benefiting from his time as much as he can. اليوم مثلا, or مثلا, today, for example, كان بالجنينة عم بيسقي الزريعة. He was in the garden watering the plants كل بعد الظهر, all afternoon. Let's continue. قال لي كمان إنه في عنده بركة على التراس كان بدها تنظيف فنظفها كتير منيح وشال العشب كله. من بعدها نكش الأرض وزرع زهور جديد. Let's break this down. قال لي كمان. قال لي, we said it means he told me. You see, I wrote it قال لي, but I pronounced it قال لي as if it's one word. You always pronounce this قال لي as one word. قال لي كمان, he told me also, إنه that في عنده, he has, بركة. بركة means a pond. عالتراس, written as عالتراس, but pronounced as عالتراس because the T is a sun letter. So we don't say عالتراس. We have to pronounce it as عالتراس, double T. So, عنده بركة عالتراس, on the terrace, كان بده تنظيف. بده means it wants, literally, and more specifically it means she wants. Why am I using بده? Because I'm referring to the word بركة, and بركة is a feminine word. That's why it requires a feminine possessive ending, the a. That's why بده is feminine. If it was a masculine word, I would have said بده with a O. But because it's not a masculine word, it's a feminine word, I'm saying بده. Literally, it means she wants. But here, I don't really mean she wants. I mean it requires. بده تنظيف. تنظيف means cleaning. So when I say بده تنظيف, it means it requires cleaning, but I'm literally saying she requires cleaning. So when I say كان بده تنظيف, I mean it required cleaning. So in the present form, you say بده تنظيف, it requires cleaning. in the past form, you add the can. Can بدها تنظيف. It required cleaning. Let's repeat this part. قال لي كمان إنه في عنده بركة. He told me also that he has a pond على التراس, on the terrace. كان بدها تنظيف. It required cleaning. فنظف كتير منيح وشيل العشب كله. ف means so. نظف means he cleaned. نظف again, we're referring to the word بركة, which is a feminine word. So I'm saying he cleaned her again, which means he cleaned it basically. فنظف كتير منيح, very well. So he cleaned it very well. وشيل, و means and. شيل means he removed. وشيل العشب. عشب means grass. العشب means the grass. كله, all of it. كل means all. كله means all of it. Why I'm saying all of it with an O in this case? Because we're referring to the word عشب, grass, which is a masculine word. That's why I say العشب كله, I don't say كله, because عشب is masculine. So فنظف كتير منيح, so he cleaned it very well, وشيل العشب كله, and he removed the grass, all of it. That's how you say basically in Arabic, the grass, all of it, which means all the grass. من بعده, after that, من بعده, نكش الأرض وزرع زهور جديد. So, نكش means he digged. نكش الأرض, literally I'm saying he digged the ground, which in this case I mean he digged the soil as well. So, he digged the soil or the ground, نكش, نكش الأرض. وزرع زهور جديد. زرع, he planted. وزرع, وزرع, pronounced as really fast. I don't say وزرع, no, I have to say وزرع as if it's just two syllables. So don't say وزرع, no, just say وزرع, وزرع. وزرع زهور جديد. He planted flowers new. Now, something very interesting is going on here. In English, you would say, he planted new flowers. In Arabic, you say, he planted flowers new. There is something else that is also interesting. Zuhur is the plural form of Zahra, by the way. It's a plural word. In Arabic, when you use a plural word, you have to use a plural adjective with it. So that's why here I say, Zuhur Jdeed. Jdeed is the plural form of Jdeed. Okay, so وزرع زهور جديد. If you want to go more into details, you could also use جديدة, the feminine singular form of the adjective. Why? Because whenever we have a plural word in Arabic and it's a non-human plural, not humans, non-human plural, I can treat it as if it's a singular feminine word and give it a feminine verb, a feminine adjective, a feminine pronoun, feminine everything. That's why here I can say زهور جديدة or زهور جديد. But you know what? In standard Arabic, you have to use جديدة 100% of the times, a feminine adjective. But when it comes to spoken Arabic, you could use both, but in Lebanese Arabic, we have a tendency to use the plural adjective more than the feminine singular adjective. So personally, I would say زهور جديد more than زهور جديدة. Okay? So new flowers, جديد. Let's repeat this part. قال لي كمان, he told me also, إنه في عنده بركة على التراس. That he has a pond on the terrace. كان بدها تنظيف. It required cleaning. فنظف كتير منيح. So he cleaned her, which means it. He cleaned it very well. وشيل العشب. And he removed the grass. كله, all of it. Which means he removed all the grass. من بعدها نكش الأرض. After that, he digged the soil or the ground. وزرع زهور جديد, and he planted flowers new, which means new flowers. بعت لي صورة الجنينة من بعد ما خلص شغل فيها، رح فرجيكن ياها. بعت لي، so بعت means he sent، بعت. بعت لي means he sent for me. You say it in Arabic, he sent to me, which means he sent me. بعت لي، بعت لي صورة الجنينة، pronounced with a liaison as صورة الجنينة. صورة means photo. صورة الجنينة، photo the garden. Let's break this down. So the word photo in Arabic does not mean surat. No, it's pronounced sura. You see here it has a ta marbuta, and all the words in Arabic that have a ta marbuta, when they are on their own, you don't pronounce this ta marbuta, the t sound. You just say sura. So when the word is on its own, if you just want to say photo, for example, you say sura. The T is there, but you're not pronouncing it. But the moment this noun is followed by another noun, which in this case is الجنينة, the garden, you start pronouncing this T sound, and instead of saying سورة, you say سورات in standard Arabic, but in Lebanese Arabic, this A kind of becomes a I, it sound, سورت. Always, سورت, not سورات. So, بعت لي سورة الجنينة. So, again, something else I want to tell you here. In English, you say the garden's photo or the photo of the garden. You have an of in English. In Arabic, this of, you don't put it. It doesn't exist. You just say photo the garden, and we understand that you mean photo of the garden, which means the garden's photo. So, بعت لي صورة الجنينة. He sent to me, or he sent me, the photo of the garden. Something else I want to tell you. You see, in English I'm saying, oops, in English I'm saying the photo of the garden, right? In Arabic you say photo of the garden. So you only need to put the to the second word, never to the first word. So when you have a noun plus noun and you have to say the, you don't say the photo of the garden. You just say photo the garden or photo of the garden. Okay? If you find this part difficult, you can press pause, repeat what I was saying, make notes. It's very, very important for you guys to make notes, and then you can continue with us. Okay? So, بعت لي صورة الجنينة. He sent me the photo of the garden. من بعد ما خلص شغل فيها. After he finished work in it or in her. Let's break this down. All of this, all together, من بعد ما, including the ما, means after. من بعد ما, memorize it as it is, after. من بعد ما خلص, خلص means he finished. So, من بعد ما خلص means after he finished. Don't get confused here. The ما is not the negative ما. No, it's من بعد ما. It's like in Arabic you are saying from after that he finished, which means after he finished. So all of this from after that doesn't make sense in English, of course not. All of it, memorize it as one word, which is after. Okay? So after he finished. من بعد ما خلص. So بعت لي صورة الجنينة من بعد ما خلص. He sent me the photo of the garden after he finished. من بعد ما خلص. شغل فيها. شغل means work, which means in this context after he finished working on it. Okay? من بعد ما خلص شغل فيها. Literally here I'm saying فيها, literally in her. But I don't mean working in her. I mean working on her. In Arabic you say فيها. شغل فيها, working in it. Why فيها? Because again, we are referring to the word جنينه, which is a feminine word. So we have to use this a fiya, which is feminine. Okay? So, من بعد ما خلص شغل فيها in it. So this is the her form, basically. You're saying in her, but you mean, of course, in it. Okay? Let's repeat this part. بعت لي صورة الجنينه من بعد ما خلص شغل فيها. He sent me the photo of the garden after he finished working on it فيها. رح فرجيكن إياها. رح فرجي is I will show. If I break it down, I write it رح فرجي. رح فرجي. You see, in Arabic, it's written with the E. رح فرجي, فرجي. But I'm pronouncing it رح فرجي when it's alone. إيه. But the moment I'm attaching the kun, you plural, in the end, I'm not saying رح فرجي كن. No, I go back to pronouncing it as a E. رح فرجي كن. رح فرجي كن. I will show you in the plural. رح فرجي كن. If I'm talking to a girl, I would say رح فرجي كي. I will show you. And if I'm talking to a guy, I say رح فرجيك. رح فرجيك. So, رح فرجيكن. I will show you. يها it. I'm saying here, I will show you her. Why am I using يها, which is feminine? Because, again, I'm talking about the word سورة, which is a feminine word. That's why I say يها. If it was a masculine word, I can't say رح فرجيكن يها. In that case, I would say رح فرجيكن يه. رح فرجيكن يه. I will show you it, masculine. رح فرجيكن يها. I will show you it feminine. Okay? So I'll repeat this part so you can repeat after me. بعت لي صورة الجنينة من بعد ما خلص شغل فيها. رح فرجيكن ياها. Let's continue. وانتو شو عم تعملوا هالايام؟ عم تقعدوا بالبيت؟ أو لا. وإنتو and you plural. وإنتو if you're talking to a guy you would say وإنت. If you're talking to a girl you would say وإنت. وإنت. وإنتو and you plural because I'm asking you guys now. وإنتو شو عم تعملوا هالأيام؟ So بتعملوا is you do in the plural. عم تعملوا means you are doing. It's present continuous in the plural form as well. شو عم تعملوا؟ شو عم تعملوا means what are you doing in the plural. شو عم تعملوا هالأيام. أيام means days. هالأيام means these days. Again, the هل is an abbreviation of usually هيدا plus L or هيدي plus L or هيدول plus L. Here it's هالأيام. You could say هيدول الأيام but it really doesn't sound natural. You have to say هالأيام, the abbreviated form. So, شو عم تعملوا هالأيام? What are you doing these days? عم تقعدوا بالبيت أو لا? So, بتقعدوا is you sit down in the plural. بتقعدوا. عم تقعدوا is you are sitting. Literally, you are sitting. عم تقعدوا بالبيت. بال means in the bed house. You see what I'm saying? I'm literally saying you are sitting in the house or are you sitting in the house. When I say are you sitting in the house, I don't literally mean if you're sitting or you're standing up. No, in this context it means are you staying home. عم تقعدوا بالبيت أو لا or no. That's how you say or no, which means or not, of course. So وانتو and you شو عم تعملوا هالأيام. What are you doing these days. عم تقعدوا بالبيت. Are you staying home أو لا or not. يلا, I'm gonna repeat the whole thing and I will give you the chance to repeat after me so that you can check your pronunciation. Make sure to focus on the sounds the ع, the خ, the غ, these Arabic sounds. Okay, يلا. من شوي كنت عم بحكي مع رفيقي روني بلبنان على التليفون. سألته كيف عم بتقضي وقتك بهالحجر. Say after me. قال لي انه عم بيشتغل من البيت هالفترة. Instead of saying من البيت, I pronounced it a bit faster and I said من البيت. Think of it as من البيت هالفترة. وعم بيستفيد من وقته قد ما فيه. اليوم مثلا or مثلا كان بالجنينة عم بيسقي الزريعة كل بعد الظهر. قال لي كمان إنه في عنده بركة، في عنده بركة عالتراس كان بدها تنظيف، فنظفها كتير منيح وشال العشب كله. من بعدها نكش الأرض وزرع زهور جداد. بعتلي صورة الجنينة. By the way, it's in my thumbnail. I'm going to show it to you through my thumbnail. من بعد ما خلص شغل فيها رح فرجيكن ياها. وانتو شو عم تعملوا هالايام؟ عم تقعدوا بالبيت او لا؟ Okay guys, that's it for today. I hope you found it useful. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm gonna say bye to you from here, from the bottom of your screen. And I shall see you tomorrow. Until then, stay safe and relax as much as you can. Bye!